Oh. Okay, the rest of them all just popped in randomly. Okay, so let's keep testing out with different foods. Now, let me see. How do these do say they can be cooked, right? Yeah, can be cooked. So, like, can I cook a special version of... Yes, I can. And can you combine them with stuff? Yes, you can. Dude, what the fuck? All the items in this game are foods. Well, we got 50 recipes that we've learned so far. Unfortunately, I don't have, like, a lot of fishies. But I'll get some fishies out, too, and we'll see what we can make with them. So I think everything in here has been combined with one another, I think. Like, Karok... Oh, apparently not. The Karok and Daggerfish. I'll use those two, then. Sharpstone dip snack. Okay. So now let me see. Let's first combine two of each golden snack, or two of each golden plant, because that will obviously create something unique. And it looks like they're shiny. If you see, they got a little sparkle symbol on them. So we're curious to see. That's recipe 52. We get rare glowing tulip salad. I'll have to look and see how what makes us special in just a moment. Got a rare spicy pepper wrap. So it looks like it'll just make it a rare variant of whatever you make. 32 food, holy fuck. Well, I can't go and live off of this stuff yet, not until I have more golden plants coming in. But still, what the hell? So, like, let me compare it. Like, rare spicy pepper wrap. Like, what if... Like, what if I combine... Like, I do mushy pepper wrap, so, like, what if I put one of these and then one of these together and see what variant that makes? Rare mushy pepper wrap. So compared, what I get is 24 food. That gives me 30 food. 21% movement for 1 minute, 10 seconds, versus 33.6% movement for 1 minute and 10 seconds. And 4.2 health regen versus 5.2 health regen. Plus, you also get a 3.8% melee attack speed for 1 minute in this one. So, holy shit, pickles. I should probably have a chest specifically for the rare stuff, the shiny stuff. I didn't make two Karoks, did I? No, okay, we'll do that. Yeah, rare crunchy stone dips. Okay. So, what else can we do here? Let's start combining. So, like, what if I combine... You and you. You and you. You and you. Man. Look at all the shit you get on that. That's incredible. Okay, that was my last golden thing there. Last golden Karok. Okay, I think we've combined all the golden stuff that I can right now. With itself, at least. Cooking one up. Good. Just learning all these new recipes. Holy jeez. How does the golden one make? It says it can be cooked. So do I need, like, a million of that just to combine it with, like, a whole bunch of other shit, too? Jeebus. Okay, I guess I'm gonna need, if I want this rare food, I'm gonna need to move this stuff up, because I need another chest here. These can't be cooked, but they are like this, and that they are just a food. Compare it with itself, but its lesser self. That's so weird. Yeah, at some point we're gonna end up having so many different recipes that I won't know what I'm missing, and I'll have to just try to deduce it. Oh, I got an extra one. That's pretty cool when you get an extra of the rare ones. Put this in there. That we can do with this right now. Yes, it looks like it. Okay. So our golden heartberry is finished. Now let's see, what about you? Can we combine anything with you? Okay, that. Yourself, we already did. Pepper, that. Karok, that. Heartberry, yes. Okay, last but not least, pepper. We've done that. We've done that. Haven't done that. Done that. Haven't done that. And haven't done that. Okay, that looks like all I can do with my gold right now. We got an extra. Nice. Give me more of the. Give me more of these extra rares. That's really helpful. Oh my god, I got another one. Okay. Just make sure that I don't have anything in there. I'm so full on shit right now. It's not even funny. All this is just different foods. Like, not a single one here is, like, stackable with something else. I'm going to need more storage. I mean, look at this. This is all different foods. This is all different foods, different foods, different foods, different foods, different foods. Not a single thing here can go with one another. Or stack on top of one another. Oh, I don't have... Oh, that's why I had an extra chest, because one was for fish. Oh, shit. Shit. I'll just put the fish in here for right now. Balls. Fiery balls. Wait, what? Oh, crap. I gotta figure out what to do with all these extra tulips. Exhausted most of our appropriations. Thank you. I'm just doing this to free up a little bit of our room. Okay. Well, I definitely want more golden plants now, because those foods looked really useful. And okay. Now we've got a 9% chance that we will grow. Oh shit, I didn't know I had one of these. We are 10 levels away from 100 on gardening. Almost maxed out on gardening, guys. Gardening. Holy shit, pickles. Gardening is definitely going to be the first Steam achievement I get for the level 100 stuff. I think what I want to do right now, I know where I want to fight that boss, which is what we're still going to do today, but I want to, I might want to try to go out and fish for a little while. Because I want to get some more fishy foods. Although, I should probably make more storage for, like, fish and stuff, because I don't really have a lot of it right now. It's sucky. I've got a copper ore in my inventory that's just sitting there. Let's do something about that. Tin. Copper. Tin. Tin. Gold. Tin. Gold. I have more tin than I do copper now. Which is kind of incredible. Let me look at it. I don't have a message notification. I've got a Discord server notification, which I'm kind of curious. Oh, let me, looking at those just reminded me. Let me take this off quick. To put that. Put that down here. Let me see. Such a weird. I don't really get that argument, to be honest. Whatever's going on in the Discord server right now. Wait, where'd the... What the hell? He's wandered off over there. Jeez, he can really wander around. How do I get him to come back in his room? Is there a way to do that? I don't know. Okay. Check out what's going on down here quick. Holy shit, look at all this stuff just laying around. More larva meat. Weapons, seeds, armor, valuables. Oh, I see a new item. Got a pickaxe. We just got ourselves a fireball staff. Which is a magic weapon that I think I found with Aki. It's from one of the mages, I believe. Oh, I can hit them over this. That is a lot of maggots. Oh, so far none of the maggots have broken out. Holy good lord. Jeez. Oh no, one of them got away. One of the little larvelets. That'll someday grow up into a bigger larva. Something died up here, apparently. I guess something must have clipped through and hit itself on this. How is there a larvelet in here, guys? There's a larvelet in where the mushroom things are. That is... What the fuck? How? I don't know. Might as well farm the rest of these places. Why not? Stuff's already spawning over there. Valuables, consumables. Wow, we got another crown summoning tool too, or idol, I mean. Peasant's hat, tin pickaxe. Fight the King Slime 4 times now. I don't know how hard he is, though. I don't know if he's like an end game boss. You summon him on the same place where you summon the big orange guy, I believe. But I don't know if he's supposed to be like, because he's a crossover boss, if he's gonna be, you know, about the same, or if he's gonna be super powerful or something. I have no fucking clue. So, like, what I could do is put a door here. I could put a door here and extend this area for more storage, maybe. I think that would work. How's our cooking going? Pretty good so far. That's gonna give us a lot of XP. A lot of cooking XP. Where are we at in cooking? 67 right now. Yeah, I want this Master Chef rare foods thing. Oh, balls. Okay, let's get some stuff repaired here. So, if we're preparing for that boss, let's go ahead and craft up some spike traps. So what I think I'll do is I'm going to make exactly 300. Yes, I'm doing this. I'll need them regardless, so we're back down to a small amount, but we collected all of that tin in just this small area of the clay biome, so I don't think it'll be that much of a problem. Okay, and now let's craft them. Can you sometimes get extra of these? No, because it said walls and stuff is what you get extra of, not like this kind of stuff. Bam, we got 300 spiky floors. I don't even know if he'll do this, because he might destroy them. I didn't even think about that, because he destroys everything else that's in front of him. So, that could be a problem. Well, we don't know. Let me see. I'm not really wanting to fight him, like, right now, but... I mean, I'll try. We'll just see what happens. See if I can even put the spike traps down correctly. Because if he kills me, then... I mean, either way, it'll be a bit of a trial and error, because I don't know how this guy works. He's just gonna, you know, squiggle by. And I don't even know if... Can I put spike traps on... Okay, yeah, I can put spike traps on the slimy stuff. So that means I don't have to dig up the ground where he's moving around in order to put stuff down. So that's already a thing. Big boobies and boobies, boobs, boobies. Give me a spike slime figurine, damn it. I don't have one of those. They're really cool looking. So what I'd want to do to test it out first is I think I'll just put some on the road and just see what happens when he roams over it. Like, if I were to say, like, oh, let's... Like, I don't know if there needs to be a pattern to it or not, but... Like, what happens if I do this? And then we'll just wait for him to come over, and then I want to see if he breaks them or not. If he breaks them, well, then that's a problem. But if he doesn't break them, well, then that's not a problem. I want to see how effective this works. Comes around. Because then I can just pick these up again after he's dead if he doesn't destroy them. And then it just works out because then I can use them for future, either for fighting him again or for future builds. So either way, I'm still getting use out of turning the tin into spike traps. Alright, I don't know. I think he comes from down here, or is it up here? I don't know which direction he's coming from, but I don't even know. He might even turn around sometimes. Oh, here he comes. He's coming from above. Oh, he takes damage. But it looks like he only takes one. He destroyed them. He actually destroyed them. And I can't catch up to him. What? Why would I want to use these then? I don't want to use these if they're going to be only a one-time thing, because that's literally a waste then of tin. And then he didn't drop them at all, did he? Like, they're not like stuck on the side, just floating around. No, he just straight up disintegrated them. Well, it's a good thing I didn't put any more down then. Got it. Okay, plan B is... I guess we can try this. Switch back and forth. Fuck, I lost 20-something spike traps there. Damn it, I didn't realize that he would actually destroy them. I thought, like, I knew he might destroy them, but I thought, like, they would just pop on the ground and then you could pick them up again. But evidently not. That's just a literal fucking waste. I'm not doing that. Not for all that tin that you have to collect. So we're gonna have to rethink this. Okay, what about explosives? Because we've got explosives that I've never used in this game before. I don't know if they work like Terraria, where you throw them and then they explode, or what, but... We could check that out. We could always test one just to see. Because I've got different bombs, and you can even craft bombs. I have even more reason to farm now when the stuff's ready, because I have higher chances of getting more gold plants, and I want those really bad. Well, now I've got spike trap. I mean, it did do a little bit of damage to him, so I'm sure if I put them all down, he probably would have died. But then it would have wasted all of my tin work, and that's just... No. I'm not doing that. Even if the game is infinite... I mean, apparently the dirt biome is not infinite. And I don't know if the clay and stone biomes are, because I don't know if there's more biomes out there beyond. But even if the clay was infinite, that's just not something I want to do. Because that's a lot of work for just a one-off thing. So... Holy shit, what the fucking hell. Dude, it's almost 10 in the morning, and I don't like this because I haven't heard anything, and it's making me feel kind of shitty. Some of this other stuff away quick. Okay, I will get these bombs out and see what the hell can we do with these. We don't have a lot. I mean, they do a lot of damage. Mining damage. Strong explosive for crowd control and facing giant enemies. Okay, like, let me take these with me. So, like, I'm gonna run out, and I want to test one of these before we go and actually fucking use it on the boss. I want to see, does it throw, or do you place? It looks like you place it. How do you, what? How does this work? Let's see. Oh, shit. That's how it works. You'd have to, he'd have to be coming, and then you'd have to line them up. And actually hope you get it lined up in time. That's the only way you'd be able to do it. And I'd probably want to use the big bombs. What does it take to craft these? Bomb peppers and slimes. That's not too bad. We got plenty of bomb peppers to go around. We got plenty of slime. How about I do that? Let's use the bigger bombs. So I'll put the little bombs away. I'll keep at least one of these in there. Let me get some slime. And let me go get some bomb peppers. These. Oh, this counts as crafting. Apparently alchemy counts as crafting. I don't think I need this many. But fuck it. I'll make that many just in case we fuck it up the first time. Because these, I already understand, we're not going to be keeping these. You know, because we're using them. That's a lot of damage, so... Oops. That's what I wanted to do. Okay. So now, I don't know about the slime sword. So what I think I'll do, then, is we will... head back down there, and I will try... First thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna whack him with the slime sword and see how much that affects him. because he doesn't stop moving. So I want to see how much it slows him down, and then I'll wait for him to come around again, and that's when I'll put the bombs down and actually try to kill him with it. So we'll see how this goes. Excuse me, what the hell? Oh, hold on. Actually, one more thing I want to do here. What I don't want to happen is I don't want him to kill me and then have him destroy my gravestone like he's destroying the spike traps, and then I lose all of whatever was in the gravestone. So I am actually going to put my love letters away so that I don't lose those. It's fine if I lose, like, the bug net, because we could just make another one of those pretty easily. Here, I'll put these in here. Okay, and we do have another room ready to go. All right, we're off. Let's do this. We could get another achievement today. As much as I would love to be doing this with Aki, she doesn't want to play the game, so there's nothing I can do about it. I have not seen the third boss. I bet since it's called the Hive Brain or Hive Mother or whatever it was called, I bet it's in that Hivey place, one of those sub-biomes or whatever. I mean, there is a scanner we can make to find it if we need to, but I still want to try to see if I can't find it on my own. I think there's more enjoyment in that. Alright, here we are. What the hell? What the fuck? What? It's the son of a bitch. Somewhere safe for me to stand. I'm assuming this is safe to stand on this like edge here. Alright, now we wait. Testing this out first, just to see how much it slows him down, and then I'll need to also test one. I mean, I'll test one of these just to see how long it takes to explode, so that way I can try to time it. Because if we don't time it correctly, we're fucked. But he comes from that way, so that's what I can remember. By recently. Oh, our map's getting filled out though. Look at that. It's incredible just how. Oh, hold on, here he comes. And there's a fucking bird right outside the window. Well, that's him being slowed down. Oh shit, what's going on? What the hell? What? I didn't know he was gonna start eating me. I'm doing it. Oh my god, he's destroying everything. I'm using my bombs. I'm doing it. Shit. That didn't work out as well. I cannot get hit again. That did some damage. See, touching his body, it was hurting me. He wasn't, like, eating me. It was touching his body. Oh, we did it! We did it! I did not know he would start attacking us. I had no idea. And he completely fucked up this part of the map. How much of this did he fuck up? Look at this! He completely destroyed this place, so it turned into a little arena. No fucking way, dude. It's a good thing I didn't do this next to anywhere important. Good lord. Well, now I know, at the very least. So all of my wooden bridges and stuff I built didn't matter. Jeez, man. I had no freaking idea. I thought the whole point... Okay, it makes sense. So that's how you're supposed to fight him. You know, it's not about trying to kill him, you know, before he gets away. It's about pissing him off so that he turns to fight you. He missed this one thing here and this one too. Just light this place up. That's what the boss fight's about. That makes total sense. And I kind of like it that way, because that means I don't have to worry about chasing him down. Okay. Well, we did it, guys. We fucking beat the second boss of the game. We got an achievement. I don't see an NPC that popped out anywhere, though. Alright, let's open the chest and see. Ooh. Our spoils. We get iron ore now. We got a larva ring, which is pretty basic. We got some mechanical parts. We've got some iron ore. 10 of that. Some fiber. A larva chest. Oh, I didn't know that their larva had armor, too. Oh my god, you can be disguise yourself as a larva. Oh, dude, that's awesome. If you get a helmet and a chest plate, you can walk through all the larva places. We gotta get that. I hope we find that someday. 20 larva meat. A Gorm's stomach bag, which is 12 inventory slots. Hello. And we get 2 special items. What is this? Gorm's horn, which is a pointy gemstone that let a larva grow way beyond its max. Oh. That was a larva. So that's what the little things will turn into if they have these horns. So I'm assuming that's what we put in the core place. And then we also have Mysterious Idol. A crystalline core statue may attract someone looking for mysterious idols if placed in a habitable room. Okay, so that's how we get the other NPC. I was right. Okay. And let me take this Gorm chest. I'm assuming that's what this is. Yep. Awesome, guys. We did it. That's so cool. Okay. I like this rush of adrenaline we've got. Now that I know how this guy kind of works, that he'll fight you in an area if you piss him off first. And we used our bombs in the end. I basically was just spamming bombs. The only reason I switched to bombs was because I was trying to kill him with melee, because I was actually doing damage, but I kept hitting his body, like touching his body, and his body was hurting me. Not his face, but his body was hurting me, and I didn't want to die to him. So I switched to something more safe and just hoped that he would charge after me while the bombs exploded, and that's exactly what happened. So that's great. Okay, well, let's go ahead and head home. And we will explore our new spoils and get a new NPC to move in. Mm-hmm. Lots of new golden plants. That's awesome. What? Oh, right. Moved it up to this chest. Just a moment while I do my usual here. Most tedious part of the LP, I know, but fuck it. It's my world, damn it. 26th right now. I was thinking it was like April 10th. I don't want it to be going through the month too fast, because things aren't going to be very happy in the coming months. Depending. Water the damn things first. I really didn't need that slime sword. I was just testing it, and once he slowed down, and I realized he was moving slow enough that I could keep whacking him with other weapons, that's why I kept following him and kept whacking on him. And then he got angry and started chasing me. Well, I am happy, though, that as far as the boss is concerned, I'm happy with the way that they've designed him when he was trying to eat me. I like the fact that he wasn't just ridiculously powerful. Like, I'm sure he would have killed me if I got in his way, but he was easy enough to avoid. And the fact that he digs out the area around you gives you an arena to run around in. And I also had the swift feather, which helped a lot too, sure, but still. Now I can place down another chest in here. I don't know what I'll use it for. So this thing that we got, this backpack, actually gives me 2 extra slots, which is really cool. I don't get the plus 1% movement speed, but I don't think that's a requirement. So apparently you can have even more inventory in this game, which is really cool. We put the slime sword away. Put the backpack away. Put that stuff away. Put this ring away. Cooking up this iron. Let me make another one of these. Don't really have anywhere to put it. I guess I can start putting them over here now. I'll probably situate this stuff better at some point, these mannequins. I'm just putting them here for right now so I can keep track of all the different armor sets that we have and what level of completion that they're at. Okay, let's go over to the core and activate this quick, because I want to see what we get. Because the slime guy, he gives us access to scanning for the next 2 bosses, and we've now fought one of those 2 bosses, so what the hell is Gorm gonna give us? You know? Like, what's his special loot gonna be for craftable items? When the fuck can I use bugs, and what the hell can I use them for? It's this thing over here, I think. Shiny. Ooh. Carapace armor. And a recall idol. Ah, that's how you get the teleport to the core stuff. That's how you can, that's the recall potions. I used one. I don't know if that was in this or if that was in my other world, but I had found one of these in one of my playthroughs that I was doing before starting this LP, unless it was in this LP, and I found it and used it thinking it was like a magic mirror from Terraria, where you have infinite uses, but it's actually a one-time use. But that's how you get it. You can craft it. Okay. Teleports you back to the core. That'll be super useful. I'm going to need to start getting those. And carapace armor, what does this do? So, you get explosives damage increase and armor. Two set gives you plus 23.8% damage for a short duration after mining a wall. That's too specific. But it's an organic body armor resembling Gorm's shell. It is heavy and feels weird on the inside. Ooh. But still, that's awesome. I like that a lot. Okay. Cool beans. We have now connected two of these things. So we have to find out where the Hive Mother is, and I'm not going to scan for her just yet. I'm going to try and see if we can't just find her through normal progression of exploration and such. Now let's put down this idol in this room and see who we can get that's new here. I'm going to have to see if you can move those guys back into place. Is he going to just pop in? There he is! Oh my god, look at this guy! How fucking cool is that? What the fuck? Okay, so he sells the idols for each of the bosses. He's got three. I don't know if that means you can only spawn three, or if he just has to, if you just need... He sells a musket and caveling bread. I'm actually curious to know, is this just limited stock? You can't get any more than this ever, or will he regenerate his stock over time? Because that would really, because the other guy had stock too, but that would really suck if you can only fight the boss three more times, and that's it, you know? So it looks like it's 500 of that coin stuff per one. And I could sell things. I could sell, like, bugs. but hey, that's cool. We got ourselves a new Mr. Man. Now I can fight. I can go and farm the one guy if I have enough money. How much money do I have? I mean, I'm sure I can, like, yeah, we can sell all of this stuff. Yeah, I don't have enough money just on hand. But I like having these. I like collecting this shit, damn it. It's fun. So I'm going to need another one of these. Because I might actually try to make that carapace armor very soon. We got lots of golden plants coming in. Oh, we got lots of golden plants. We got three golden Karoks, two golden heartberries, looks like three golden bomb peppers, three golden tulips, and lots of gold. And how close are we? Oh, we're still quite a ways off. But it looks like we get just about one gardening level every time we harvest. Oh shit, I didn't realize we finished this. What are our new things? Alchemist, plus 4% chance to gain an extra item when crafting any item at the alchemy table or distillery. Okay, there's apparently a distillery at some point. Industry specialist, plus one extra item gained when crafting rails, wires, or conveyor belts. Well, that sounds way more useful than the bomb thing. But then again, I don't know what you make at a distillery. I'm thinking bombs, but then what about health potions? Extra health potions would be nice. Crafting items at the anvil and repairing items cost 5% less materials. Oh, that's actually so useful. But this one was way better. what are the last ones? Unbreakable. 6% armor while at low health, or 10% chance to gain a polished version of any item crafted at the jewelry workbench. 10% chance to gain a polished... What the hell is a polished version? I guess it's like just a better version. Shoot, I don't actually know what one to go with here. I mean, you can reset these, but I guess. Alright, this just seems more useful to me, the industry specialist, especially since it takes tin and stuff, I think, to craft. Does it? Well, shit, now I should probably go check. Yeah, tin. Okay. So I guess I'll get 6 from it every time now. Okay, cool. We got ourselves another NPC. And that means... Oh, let me get my love letters out. I cannot get this guy to come back in, which fucking sucks. I'm gonna have to look that up. And you know what? 50 minutes on this video. I'm gonna go ahead and stop this video here, and I'm gonna look up and see if you can move NPCs around at all. But I'll see you guys in the next episode.